Okay, good morning to all of you. So we are observing topic number 4, so cultivation. We have seen the two examples as mentha and the eucalyptus. Then there is a general one point is there, the for cultivation methods, then factors affecting cultivation, collection and processing. So we are going to see about the collection, harvesting, drying, garbling, packing, storage of the crude drugs are there. So while going to this topic, already we have seen the eucalyptus and the mentha, but we have to focus on these some factors affecting. So we would start from the first factor about the soil. So which is the altitude is there, the first one, right? Then secondly, temperature and the humidity of this particular area. Then nextly, about the rainfall and the irrigation is there, right? Then nextly, the soil and the soil fertility. Then use of the fertilizers, natural fertilizers, FYM, farmyard manure, or the there are the other NPK and the other doses are there. Then pest and the control. It is also a factor affecting the cultivation of medicinal plants. Then about the plant hormones are there. So starting from the propagation, we are knowing root hormones are there. Then there are the after the spraying are there. Then polyploidy. So there should be a trueness to the type. So suppose the any plant is having the good quality character, but how the hybrids are produced, so it is also studied. Then nextly, there is having the greenhouse effect. Nowadays temperature changes are there, so either it is cultivated under shade net or polyhouse or the greenhouse, and most important part to develop the new hybrid varieties, so hybridization technique is there. So just you remember all these points for our study. Then in the factors affecting, which are the special attention for the cultivars are there. Cultivars, that is the farmers who are going to cultivate particular. So altitude related to the which is influencing factor. So therefore the from the sea level, generally at which altitude it is growing. Then temperature and humidity. Then rainfall, irrigation. So all these factors. Then soil and soil fertility, already we have seen. So altitude is the main. We'll see the one by one. In altitude, it increases the temperature and atmospheric pressure. Then wind velocity is also related to this, relative humidity, and the light intensity increases. Secondly, it also shows the due to the height, there is it produce the vegetation, different vegetation pattern. Good example are tea, cinchona, or the eucalyptus. The cinchona is in Marathi also called as cinchona, bark is there. Then it grows up to the 1000 to 2000 meter. Then cinnamon, we are meaning cardamom, cinnamon dalchini, cardamom vilaichi. So it grows up to the 1000 meter from the sea level. The at 1000 senna leaves can be cultivated at the sea level. Other good examples are there. You remember this clove up to 900 meter, camphor, was a kerpur tulas. So muntapan thala. So generally it is 1500 to 2000 meter. Then cinchona bark. Then temperature is the limiting factor. So temperature, it is a major, as it is directly proportional to the light intensity. So generally due to sudden temperature decrease, ice crystals are there. There may be loss of the plant in the intercellular spaces. Or suppose high temperature, it causes the drought or the desiccation, that is drying of the plant is there. Secondly, the photosynthetic activity also affected. Respiration increases and due to the increase in temperature like this. Then there is atmospheric humidity. Humidity means what? Cold vapor percentage in the air. It is called as humidity. So if temperature is more, transpiration is more. If it is less, transpiration is less. So good example, you remember at 60 to 75 degree Fahrenheit, it is the cinchona growing good. So actually Fahrenheit is the unit used for temperature, but we are using degree Celsius. So I think 2.5 degree Fahrenheit equal to 1 degree Celsius. For coffee 55 to 70, for tea 70 to 90 Fahrenheit. You remember any one example. Then rainfall. So rainfall is very important. Suppose xerophytes are there, so they require less water, and there is having their proper irrigation important. As per the rainfall, it influence on medicinal plant cultivation, so it also effect on the soil. Secondly, snowfall is there, suppose low temperature, so it also affect. Good example, saffron or this, so they are growing at the low temperature. Then suppose there are the rainfall generally, as there is having the good example, you see the example, continuous rainfall lead to a loss of the water and the soluble substances from the leaves and the root leaching is there, right? Then soil and the soil fertility, it is important, already we are knowing. So soil is with 16 types of the minerals are there. NPK are major 3 and 13 are the others, calcium, magnesium, phosphate, zinc, iron, etc. Right. Then secondly, so soil gives the mechanical strength, anchorage to the this plant. And secondly, there are the soil, as per the soil type, the soil fertility is there. So as per the nutrition, then there should be having a well decayed and decomposed humus or organic matter. Right, so therefore microorganisms play the important role is there. The pH of the soil is also important. 6.5 to 7.5 pH is supposed ideal, and near not acidic, not alkaline. So therefore if more alkaline, we may add the gypsum into the soil, so for maintenance of pH. Then different 5 components are there. The soil made up of mineral matter, soil air, soil water, organic matter and the humus. So types of soils we are knowing: clay, loamy, silt, sandy and the calcareous. Clay soil, it based on the coarse size of the particles, so 0.002 to 0.02 millimeter. Then loamy, 30 to 50% with clay. Then silt, 20 to 30% clay. And size is the silt 0.02 to 0.2 millimeter. So as per particle, then sandy soil, the particles are larger, 0.2 to 200 mm. So it is sand, and 10 to 20% clay. The clay is very calcareous. That is the 20% loam is there. Loam, that is your chunkhadi, Marathit mantra upon calcium carbonate. So remember these types: clay, loamy, silt, sandy, and the calcareous. Then clay soil having the character, as it shows the intercellular spaces in the two particles, it is less because they are very smaller. And therefore it physiologically it immediately dry up, and it having the more also not dry up, and it hold the more water. Then loamy soil is there, so it is showing the mixture of clay silt, and therefore as it is to be used as a good nutrient. Silt soil generally, as it shows the organic substances. Sandy soil, particles are larger, it holds the less water. Calcareous, 20% loam is there, right? In sandy also, the due to the large particle size, the water drain off is more, and therefore generally it is called as a poor soil, right? And it is less fertile. So any type of soil contain less 0.5% organic matter is described as the poor soil. A rich soil, soil contain organic matter 1.5 to 5%, rich soil, and intermediate 0.5 to 1.5%. then fertility of soil, it is based on this generally there is having the character is there. So as soil fertility is there, so it shows the amount of balanced type of the all nutrients are there. And generally, therefore, the manures, the nitrogen fixing bacteria, and the different chemical fertilizers. In fertilizers, we are knowing there are the synthetic fertilizers are generally there, NPK, and these are acting as a good nutrient for the plant development and the growth. Secondly, as they also helps for the modifying the water retention and aeration. The fertilizers directly effect on the plant, and therefore soil fertility, then improvement of the crop development and the production and the crop quality, it is very important. So we are knowing the addition of the these fertilizers. You are observing these good photographs with the organic matter fertilizers, then natural fertilizers, FYM is there, farm yard manure, compost, right? Then in the biological origin of fertilizers are there. So they are grouped in three types: manures, then manures into three: farmyard, composited manure, and the green manure. Farmyard already we are knowing, our cow dung manure or the poultry manure. Composited manure is the organic nitrogen supplement, bone meal or the fish meal are there. Green manure, neem seed cake, vermicompost or the oil cake is there, right? किंवा आपल्याकडे ताक करतात बघा, ग्रीन मॅन्युअर ताक, राईट. देन इन बायो फर्टिलायझर्स देर आर द डिफरंट नाव डेज यूज्ड बीजीए कल्चर्स, बॅक्टेरिया, अल्गी, राइझोबियम, एजोटोबॅक्टर. सो दीज आर द मेजर आर देअर इन मेजर न्यूट्रियंट NPK, नायट्रोजन, फॉस्फरस, पोटॅशियम. सेकंडरी न्यूट्रियंट जस्ट आय अबव डिस्कस. सो कॅल्शियम, मॅग्नेशियम, सल्फर. Then micronutrients are the boron, chlorine, copper, iron, zinc, molybdenum, right? Then elements, they are all necessary for the plant growth and the development. So these are different contents are there. For example, from air and water and soil, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. From soil and fertilizers, chlorine. It is generally getting than the other content. The major nutrients, nitrogen, plays the important role. It is for the good, for vigorous growth, good leaf color and photosynthesis, right? So different crops. Then phosphorus necessary, it helps the root development, helps the strengthen the plant. It increases the flowering, it is called as the bloom. And generally it is good for the bulbs, perennials or the certain plants are there. Potassium improves the overall health of the plant. Therefore, in the hot and the cold climate condition, weather conditions, and the uptake of the other nutrients takes place with the, due to the potassium. So therefore, these are necessary. In the secondary nutrients, we are knowing calcium, magnesium, sulfur are there. So calcium generally promote vigor and the good growth. Vigor, that is the growth. It helps the to build up cell walls. Magnesium generally, it regulate the plant generally seeds formation and the plants to develop the seeds or chlorophyll content. Then sulfur necessary to maintain the green color and encouraging the more vigorous growth. Other trace elements we are knowing, they helps for the plant metabolism, boron. Then chlorine involved in the photosynthesis, copper involved metabolize the nitrogen, iron assist in the manufacture of chlorophyll and biochemical process are there. Like all these one, molybdenum is as a natural. Then the main factor affecting to the medicinal plant is the different pest and different diseases are there. So types of pest we are knowing, insect pest are there. So fungi are also there, adult moths, flies, larvae. Then the fungal these pest are there. So methods for the, all these one to control the pest. So hand pickling or remove of insects, then pruning, burning, trapping of the pests are there, right? Then agricultural different methods are there, use of the insecticide, fungicide, herbicide, rodenticides, for rodent control rodenticides, pesticides, fungus fungicides. And generally insecticide, you remember some good example: DDT, Gamaxion, Malathion. Fungicide, Borax mixture, chlorophenols, antibiotics. Herbicides, 2,4-dichloroxyacetic acid, 2,4-D. We are commonly calling as the 2,4-D. Right. So just you remember all these characters are there. Then nextly, in this relation, about different plant hormones are there. So this is also a factor. Nowadays changing climate, it requires the certain type of the or these use of hormones are there. So general plant hormones for the either inhibiting the growth or for the proper growth is there. So auxins for cell elongation, these are called as the phytohormones related to sunlight. Gibberellins for cell elongation, cell division. Cytokinins for cell division, then inhibit senescence. Inhibit, that is the reduce. Abscisic acid, abscisicin of the leaves, that is the, it shows the functioning or the metabolism. Ethylene promote the senescence, then epinesti and the fruit ripening. Or we are knowing the unripe fruits, they are collected, harvested from the field and kept in the ethylene vapors so they can mature. So all these factors are we have seen for our this today's lecture. So remember all these one, okay? Remaining we are in the next lecture starting the our topic number 5. Okay, thanks to all.